So when it says, it is you who we worship and you we ask for help, Christians are wondering, who is Allah talking to?
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.
Who is talking? It is you who we worship. So Allah is talking about himself.
Yes.
And it talks to himself.
Yeah, I agree.
For example, praying for. Yeah. For your mom.
Yeah.
If she's sick, you can pray for.
Allah prays
your friend.
For.
Yeah, he's praying for people.
Allah's praying for
yeah.
people.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's what he said. Not yeah. blessing.
Then God tell him. Yes. Tell him. No, Musa. Tell him, yes, I do, but the way I am praying.
But you so you admit God said, yes, I do.
So God praying, yes.
You understand it?
Israelite. Everything came out. Take it away.
Yeah. So people need explanation.
The line. Oh, you can keep going around.
I don't like.
Okay, we'll do another one. I'm going to debate Hashim in a bit. Hashim, we're going to do our Tawheed today.
Depends.
Yeah, but depends. Yes, it depends.
I'm in the middle of a conversation.
So
what was the question the Israelites asked?
I will translate because this is I will translate exactly word by word. So
yes.
Israelite went to Musa.
Yes.
They asked him, does God pray?
Exactly.
Moses initially he said
so
no.
So the question was, does but let's first they asked him, does your God pray?
Yes.
Okay.
But Moses said, fear God.
Yes.
He was shocked, you know.
Okay. So the preposition of this whole hadith is based on their question. Does your Lord pray?
So Moses was shocked from the question. Yes. He says, fear God.
Yes.
Then God told him,
yes.
Tell him, no, Musa, tell him, yes, I do, but the way I am praying.
So you admit God said, yes, I do?
So God praying, yes.
Okay.
Yes, I do, but my prayer is sending blessing to my servant. This is what the translation. Ask any Arabic man.
What is the word that Allah says? No, you read the Arabic.
Arabic here? I read Arabic.
Yeah, give us the Arabic where he said. So you say the Arabic word and I'll read the English. So
we should get Christian Arab. Maybe you will believe this word, linguistically.
Yes. He said then.
Okay.
So he said then I'll read the English and you give the Arabic.
Because
so said,
the English maybe is not because the way they write it maybe I will just give word by word. Okay.
Yeah.
First of all,
listen to this. قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى عليه السلام. So. Children of Israelite went to Musa and they asked him, okay, am I right now? And
yes.
He will verify what I'm saying. هل يصلي ربك فقال موسى, does your God
pray?
So the question, so Musa replied,
yes.
Okay, what he said, اتقوا الله يا بني إسرائيل.
Okay.
Okay.
Did he say no?
He didn't say no.
Okay.
He said, fear God.
Okay.
He was shocked by the question.
So that question fair still God. Needs to be answered.
Yeah.
Okay.
So God, then God.
Okay.
Yes.
And then they sent him to the
room. Then God told Moses.
Yes.
Told the people yes.
Yes.
They came again, and then they.
Yeah, Musa, mother.
So say it again. God came down and said.
No, no. God revealed to him. Came
yeah,
down.
Yeah. God revealed.
Revealed to him.
Yeah.
And he asked Moses, what your people asking you?
Yes.
And then Moses told God.
Yes.
God, you know what they've asked.
Yeah.
He said, yes. Tell
said
them.
Yes.
Yeah, God, he knows.
So he's admitted that he
prayed. No. Tell them.
But that's what you said. God, wait. Let me just repeat the point.
I am translating word by word.
Yeah, exactly. But
Moses said.
Finish.
Yeah, but let me just clarify. I know what you're saying, but look. Because
I didn't finish.
But let me just make the statement. Because he just said.
The
question was repeated to Allah, and then Allah said yes. So then what is Allah saying yes to? Because they want their question answered.
Allah told Musa, tell them, yes, I do pray.
Yes.
But my prayer is blessing.
Where's the word blessing? What's the word for blessing here?
Rahmati.
Ram, mercy.
Rahmati, mercy,
yeah,
and blessing.
Yeah, but that's mercy there. So I want the exact word for blessing. Because here in English it says, tell them my prayer for my servants is that my mercy, which is Rahma, should precede my anger.
Yeah.
So you, I'm sure asking you, then Rahma should be used twice because I want the word for my prayer. You said that is mercy. So where is the word used for mercy that is for prayer?
It says here.
So it says Rahma twice?
Yeah. No, it says.
Exactly.
You misunderstood the point. Okay, Ali. He maybe he understands Arabic. You read Arabic?
Okay.
He said,
the preposition
Quran is quite difficult.
No, this is a hadith.
Hadith.
Yeah.
قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى عليه السلام.
كبرها كبرها شوية.
Can you enlarge it?
No, that's
What's that?
قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى عليه السلام.
Yeah, yeah. So, the Israelis.
هل يصلي ربك؟ فقال موسى اتقوا الله يا بني إسرائيل.
Yeah, fear Allah.
Fear Allah. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So the preposition of this hadith is what?
So still, so
the preposition.
Preposition.
Oh my God! Yeah. The you're jumping to the end.
No, no. But let's just start so you understand what it's about.
He will translate to you.
Yeah.
What do you understand?
I don't
so
know
far?
About the context, but
yeah, yeah. But what you understand so far?
What does this mean?
Yeah, yeah.
They ask the Israelites to ask Moses.
From what you have read in Arabic now.
Yeah.
Can you say it in English? You understand?
Say what?
So what you have read in Arabic?
Hold on. Let him read.
Okay, if you read it again.
I've read two lines.
Yeah.
Okay. Continue.
There's nothing there.
Yeah, we're breaking it down.
No. Let him read, and after that you can break it down.
قال الله لحظة يا موسى ماذا قال what's that? What did your people tell you, or your tribe? What did your tribe?
So, Israelites have gone to Moses.
Let us continue.
Again, I don't know the context.
You
show me one. You show me one page. You show me one line.
Yeah.
Qala ya Rab, O Lord, my Lord. Yeah. ما قد
ما قد علمت قالوا.
ما قد علمت
قالوا.
You already know. They said.
قالوا.
هل يصلي ربك عقال؟
يصلي.
Is that يصلي or يصلي؟
Yeah, يصلي. Yeah.
What is that? Does he pray?
Yeah. Okay. What was the answer?
To your Lord, he said.
Yeah.
فأخبره. Then he told them. إن صلاتي لهذا. My prayers.
My prayers.
Are for my slaves.
Thank you.
Okay. And تسبق. So explain.
His prayers. So he's answered their question. Does your Lord pray? And he said yes.
Who's preceded? Yeah. Who has
my mercy precedes my prayer?
Yeah. So he's praying to his mercy.
غضبي.
That's what it says.
My mercy. What's that? Anger. My anger. رحمتي غضبي.
أن تسبق رحمتي غضبي.
So that my mercy will come before my anger.
He didn't say my blessings are for my mercy to precede my anger. He said my prayer is for my mercy to precede my anger.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's not very clear.
Yeah, but that's
right?
why I said we start with their question. Okay. Their
the point is,
was does your Lord pray? That's the basis of this. So they didn't ask him.
I don't know the context. I'm not taking any stand on any of this.
Yeah, but
I'm just reading a passage.
It's against you, paper boy.
This is the context.
That's the answer. God's prayer means will send his mercy will.
Was their question, does your Lord bless? No, their question was, does your Lord pray?
That's why Moses
was shocked.
Okay, what was the answer? Answer, Allah says to Moses, yes, I pray. My prayer is blessing, preceding my anger on my servant.
I've got another one from Ibn Hisham.
I'll
give you a context. Because look, it says, one more. It says, I, Muhammad, said, O Gabriel, does your Lord pray?
Yes.
The same question again.
Yeah,
he says, yes.
Yeah.
I said, what does he say?
Yeah.
This is what he says. He says, glory, holy Lord of the angels and the spirit. My mercy overcome my wrath. Again, it's a prayer. He's asking him, does your Lord pray? It's not. They didn't ask him.
Mercy.
Come on. It's the word. Does he say, does your Lord give barakah? No, he says, does your word
barakah, you know, you have to learn Arabic.
Because
you are,
you see, you're trying to change it. Because what
Because
happens,
Arabic
what we
language
see,
is very vast.
No.
For one thing, he knows, he learned Arabic. But he knows.
I'm going to find the meaning.
Okay.
Barakah, mercy, salah.
Okay, now, In Ibn, 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 Ibn
Allah, now, Arab.
Say blessings, praise.
Look, not this praise. This is the Arabic. This is from the dictionary.
Arabic language is very vast.
What's the word there? Actually, he will know. What is the word there?
I'd say, Ibtihad.
Ibtihad, Salah.
Salah. What does it say? Prayer, litany, long prayer in the Christian church, solemn prayers, evocation, prayer, beseeching or pleas, asking for help from God.
Yeah, this Salah. Is one meaning.
This is from a dictionary.
Which dictionary? It's
more than this nine is
from Google Translate.
No.
Lisan al-Arab.
And from, let's see, we got even Ibn al-Athir. He has a dictionary. He has a dictionary called Al-Niya fi Garib al-Athir. And he explains Salah as follows. Al-Salah and Al-Salawah, used for a particular kind of worship, its literal origin is supplication. Sometimes Salah is referred by mentioning it from his, you can go and check his dictionary, Al-Athir.
He's in a dictionary.
I'll show you who he was.
Look. Salah, Allah can also mean yes, to bless.
To pray for.
It can mean to bless, to pray for, to worship.
To bless. Yeah.
This, so, this is with the proposition Allah, which
is yeah, the meaning. Yeah, but exactly, that's what they're trying to say. But if you, because in, if you look at in the Quran.
I don't know the other two also. No, the four main ones.
To look after or to look like.
Another weak ones.
We have to ask the dictionary to find many synonyms.
No, because if you have Allah and the angels pray, what they're trying to say is if you have.
Praying for.
Yeah, I agree.
For example,
praying for.
You can pray for your mom.
Yeah.
If she's sick, you can pray for
Allah prays
your friend.
For.
Yeah, he's praying for people.
Allah's praying for people.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what he said. Not blessings.
Yeah. It means. He just told you. Yeah, I agree with him. I agree. But praying, when God praying upon his servant, means mercy.
Yeah, he's wishing
mercy.
People.
Mercy on them. A dictionary, he just showed you the meaning of the prayer.
What is the overall point that you're trying to make? I don't want to be a cameraman.
Well, you've entered, so...
No.
You have to wait, because he's filming.
You're doing strawman arguments.
No.
We just brought you a dictionary. Which dictionary are you
using?
Because if we go to Al-Athir...
Let him just make overall point.
He knows the same point, weeks and weeks
of it. What is the overall point?
Are we listening? Al-Athir was an esteemed scholar of the Shafi Madhab, best known for his works on hadith, lexicography, and grammar.
Dictionary.
He has his own dictionary.
Let us see a
dictionary. He has a dictionary.
Pepper boy.
This is an Islamic scholar called Al-Athir.
Pepper boy.
Now, you've heard of him. Thank you very much.
Pepper boy.
Now, wait, let me.
I'm going to read to you what he says in his dictionary. So he says, Al-Salah and Al-Salawah, used for a particular kind of worship. Its literal origin is supplication. Sometimes Salah is referred to by mentioning one or more of its parts. It is also said that the literal origin of the word is to glorify, and the particular worship is called Salah because it entails glorification of the word of the Lord. So this is from.
So what's your point? What's your point then? What's
so
your
I'm
point?
Saying this is from Al-Athir.
Okay, what's your point? What's your point?
So I'm asking you, who is Allah praying to?
Nobody.
This is the question we have all been asking for.
You the answer, we just answered you.
And okay,
The word you're given a definition of is prayers.
And what is it's a form
the word, of dua. The word we've been looking at is a verb.
Salah, yes. Allah.
And it's a transitive
prayer.
It's a transitive.
Yes, but that is not what you're describing. Yeah. Is not the verb with this preposition.
A transitive verb does not change on the pronoun.
It does, he studied Arabic.
I'm telling you, the meaning of the verb changes slightly when you add a preposition.
He studied Arabic,
He's not a Muslim.
He's not a Muslim, he studied Arabic.
Are we listening to what I'm saying? So now,
the reason why
I'm saying this is because if we, for example, even go to some Ali Dashti, this is what he says. Furthermore, the Quran contains sentences which are incomplete and are not fully intelligible without the aid of commentaries, foreign words, unfamiliar Arabic words, and words used with other than the normal meaning, adjectives and verbs inflected without observance of the concord of gender and number, illogically and grammatically applied pronouns which sometimes have no referent, and predicates which in rhyme passages are often remote from their subject.
These and other such aberrations in the language have given scope to critics who deny the Quran eloquence. Now, I'll give you an example. In the Quran, for example, when Allah gives an instruction, he normally says say or O Muhammad. Yes? Do you agree?
I'm jumping to another point?
It's gonna refer to this point. Yeah. Do you agree? Do you want me to give you some Quranic verses to
okay, continue, what's your point?
So, Surah Al-Fatiha.
Yeah.
Who is talking?
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen.
Yeah. Who's speaking?
He's speaking.
Allah or a person?
Allah speaking.
Okay.
Allah speaking.
Yeah.
So, let's...
What's your point?
Okay. Can you recite?
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm al-Din, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'een.
Okay. So when it says, it is you we worship and you we ask for help, who is talking?
Who's talking? Allah is talking.
Who is it we worship?
We, the way we pray, Allah is the Quran revealed to
Prophet Muhammad. Allah is praying in this verse.
Not Allah, we, Allah, Quran is Allah's word.
Yes.
And this one, Allah asks us the way we pray, Surah Al-Hamd.
Okay, show me where Allah asks you. I ask you, when Allah says say.
Straw man argument.
No, show me where there's an instruction.
Straw man argument. It's not
Allah is prayed in Surah Al-Fatiha.
Have you studied
where
Arabic?
Is it? No. I started this. I asked them very clearly. I asked you very clearly. When Allah speaks, he says say, or he gives an instruction. So I'm asking you, where is the instruction here?
I'm asking you first my question.
There's no instruction. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen.
Who is talking? It is you who we were. Allah is talking about himself.
Yes.
Allah is talking to himself.
No, talking about himself. About himself. Talking to himself.
He said it's
himself.
You who we worship. So Allah is worshipping. So therefore Allah is praying to himself.
Allah,
so when we ask you who is Allah praying to, you're saying Allah is praying to himself. Where is the instruction? When the Quran, it says, normally it says, Allah will say Muhammad or tell the people of the book. Show me where Allah is given instruction. Because this is then will be inconsistent with the rest of the Quran.
No, it's not inconsistent.
Where's the instruction? I'm asking you. There's the Quran. Show me where the instruction is. Where's the instruction?
What's your point? What's your point?
I'm asking you, this is evidence that Allah prays. Because Allah, Surah Al-Fatiha is a prayer.
Yeah.
And there's no instruction for the people to pray. Because normally in the Quran, Allah will say Muhammad, or tell the people the scripture. He'll give them a direct instruction. So if this is an instruction for people to pray, it should have, oh Muhammad, tell the people of the book, or say in terms of recitation. So when he's saying...
No, there is no instruction to pray this one.
Yeah, so...
Who told you this is instruction?
I'm showing you.
It's not instruction, this one.
It's to Allah's
praying. Information. No, it's not instruction. This is information.
Well, so Allah
it's
is talking.
Instruction. Yeah, Allah's talking.
So Allah
it's
is saying, it is you who we worship.
Huh? Yeah.
So he's talking about himself.
I'm talking on,
who is
on,
he?
On behalf of his creation. Allah most wise.
So Allah's saying, praying to himself. Because this is why Christians ask you, who is Allah praying to? So when it says, it is you who we worship and you we ask for help, Christians are wondering, who is Allah talking to? Because he's not saying, it is me who you worship.
He's not giving instruction, he's giving information.
Exactly. Maybe there's a...
It's not
because we're asking who's Allah giving supplication to.
It is not instruction.
Hold on. This Fatiha,
yes.
When was it revealed?
This was apparently
when
the beginning.
When was it revealed?
The beginning.
The beginning of what?
Of his ministry or whatever. So you tell us.
This is your claim, yes?
Okay.
You see your claim. Fatiha is your claim, yes?
I'm asking you, who's talking?
It's your claim.
Who's talking?
What's my claim?
You show us this Fatiha.
This is information, not order, by the way.
Allah is praying, but he said, who's talking?
Yes.
Do you know the context?
So give me the context.
No, I'm not. You show. You
have
claim.
A problem.
I'm asking you a question. Who is Allah talking to? When Allah says, it is you who we worship and who we ask for help.
They're not using your Bible.
Did you show us this Fatiha?
Did I show it to you?
Yes. You were showing to us this Fatiha, yes?
Yeah.
What is the context?
Tell me.
I'm not. This is your claim.
The context is Allah is talking to
you
someone.
You see, someone, yeah, this guy,
Allah's talking to someone.
Picky.
I'm asking you who's talking.
I know, but I will not give it to you. Do you know why? This is your claim. You cherry picky,
no,
and you don't know
because
the context.
Because this started off saying, who does Allah give salah to?
Let me finish my point.
So we're asking now, who is Allah talking to in this point?
Can I finish my point? You are cherry picky, why? Because you're showing us some verses.
Yes.
You don't know when it was revealed. You don't know the context.
Okay, tell us.
Saying, I'm not. This
we
is
want
your
to
job.
Know.
This is your job. No,
Yes, the context is Allah. Okay, I'll give you the context. Allah's talking to himself.
Exactly. So what? So what? So what?
Good luck, my friend.
So who? Why is Allah saying it is you who we worship and you who we ask for help?
That's all that is. Guide. It's a guide for us. Not a guide.
Where is the instruction?
Guide.
Because I asked you, I started
information.
Off.
No.
No, but I started off and I said.
I explained to him about Salah Allah, now he's jumping.
No, because that's this is an example. No, this is an example of where jumping. Allah is talking about supplication. So this goes back to the prayer, because this is a prayer,
no problem,
yes?
No problem.
So I'm asking you, who is Allah talking to in here?
Okay, no problem. Now, you were, earlier on, you telling me, you told me that Sahih, what is the verse? The verse, Al-Azab, 33, I don't know which verse, 35, 46, 56, yes, he's wrong. Show me, at least three translations, they say it's bread.
Okay, and, it's not bread. I'll give you a translation, let's see.
Three.
It's not an order, this one, by the way.
Yeah?
It's not an order.
Okay, give me one.
Okay, give you one.
I know which one he's going to give me.
Which one?
Okay, go ahead.
No, you say.
Yes,
I've got
I know.
It. You
okay,
tell me.
You are not honest, paper boy, because okay, people answered you this one many times.
You tell
okay,
me.
Show me,
I've got
me.
It. Okay.
I want to show you.
All right. I'm going to go. Okay, I've got the Quran. Dr. Ghali. It says, surely Allah and his angels shower serenity, literally shower prayers on the Prophet. Oh, you have believed, pray for benediction on him. And as we can see, this is a Quran. It's not my Quran.
Yeah,
it's translated by a linguist.
What's wrong with that?
Dr. Ghali? Who is he?
He's a linguist.
That's what we're saying.
Yes.
Dr. Ghali?
Yeah.
Really?
It's not my Quran. I didn't make this Quran.
Do you know
Quran.
Who is
he? Huh?
Do you know who is he?
It's a Quran. You asked me for
Dr.
one
Ghali.
Translation.
Ghali.
I've given it to
Dr.
him.
Dr. Ghali, who is he?
He's an Egyptian linguist.
Do you know what?
Yes, I know
he's
who he is.
He's a Coptic Christian, my brother.
All right. Okay. So we've got Quranic translation. No, he's not a Coptic Christian. Show me the evidence. Show me the evidence. Show me the evidence. That he's a Coptic Christian.
Show me
the evidence.
I know this guy.
Okay, he has not given any evidence. So but let me
just
show the camera.
Next time I'll show you
okay,
the
next
evidence.
Time you show me.
Yeah, next Sunday.
Next time you show
me.
No. But as we see, look at the translation. It's not my Quran. He asked me for one translation, and it says, surely Allah and his angels shower serenity, literally shower praise on the Prophet. Oh, you who have believed, pray for benediction on him, submit in full submission. So I've given him one translation.
No, don't worry. He's got internet. He's going to show you.
So, but they are diverting from, I asked a simple question. Who is talking in Surah Al-Fatiha? And show me the instruction that is for Muslims.
Show you.
How do you know it's for a guide?
It's not
because
order.
I asked you originally.
It's a guide.
Is it true in the Quran when Allah is giving Dr. instructions, he'll normally say, "Say
Ali.
Muhammad," or tell the people the scripture.
Yes.
Because when it's an instruction, a God has to communicate the instruction. But if Allah is talking, who is he talking to?
He's talking to the people.
He's talking to the people. Yeah. Show me. The Quran is very clear, so I'm asking for evidence.
The message that is sent to you. That's it.
What's his name, Ghali? What?
I thought you know him.
Yeah, so, I know it, but okay. He doesn't know.
You tell him.
Yes.
Dr. Ghali, what?
He knows him.
What's his second name?
He said he knows him.
Yeah, tell me the name.
No. He said he knows him.
Dr. Ghali, what?
He knows.
Just tell us.
No. He said he knows, so he can find him. I'm not. No. If he knows, he'll find him.
What's the name? Give me the name.
No. He knows. He said he knows him, so I'm not helping. No. He said he knows. He made a claim.
I know. I will show you next Sunday.
Show him his name.
No. You show him his name. Because I'm not helping. He was very confident. He knows who this person is, so he doesn't need my help.
Give me full name. His name.
He knows him.
No.
دكتور غالي شو؟
دكتور غالي
ترجمة القرآن غالي ترجمة مترجم القرآن.
Oh, you can come back next week if you want. Then you
now
yeah.
Show me.
What's the argument about?
You know my claim.
They'll come back next week because they're taking too long. So today this debate is over. We'll wrap up and then we'll wait till next week. So as we see, we don't know who Allah is.
You know my claim.